It's an ordinary school day, just like any other. As usual, I'm surrounded by couples and friend groups walking to school together. I always tell myself, it's about time I meet some girls or something like that. Yo yo ish yo. Well, there's already one girl. This girl is Sayori, my neighbour and good friend since we were children. Welcome back. We used to walk together to school every day, and recently we've picked up that habit once again. Yo yo, are you proud of me? For what? You know, for waking up on time. Well, you've been doing that for a while now. Wow. But you never even said anything about it, even though we walked to school together every day. Well, yeah, I've always thought it was implied. It's embarrassing to say out loud. Come on, please. It's good motivation for me. Fine. I'm proud of you, Sayori. Nice. We cross the street together and make our way to school. As we draw near, the streets become increasingly speckled with other students making their daily commute. By the way, have you decided on a club to join yet? A club? I told you already, I'm really not into that. I start to say what I always do, that I'm not interested in joining any clubs, but something tells me Sayori would take a lot more offence to that now. After all, how could I tell her that clubs are a waste of time when she's starting a club of her very own? Also, Sayori's club president now. Actually, yeah. I think I've decided on a club.
Really?
Which one? I think I'll keep it a surprise.
Aw, boo. Meanie.
Be patient, you'll find out soon enough. I used to ask myself why I let myself get lectured by such a carefree girl. But I started to realise that in a way, I envy her. When Sayori puts her mind to something, she can accomplish great things. So that's why I feel like I should do something special for her. The school day is as ordinary as ever, and it's over before I know it. After I pack up my things, I stand up, gathering my motivation. Alright, let's see. I recall the room number of the club from a flyer I saw. I walk around the school and then upstairs, a section of the school I rarely visit, as it's generally used by third year classes and activities. Before long, I find the room. I timidly open the door in front of me.
Hey, hey, hey.
Yo, ush yo, what are you doing here? Oh, I just... Hey, I glance around the room. Oh, so you're the Ushio that Sayori's always talking about. Thanks for stopping by. It's a pleasure to meet you. We're in the literature club. Alright, I hope you enjoy your visit. Come on, Yuri. No need to be so formal. He's gonna think that we're really strict or something. Oh, sorry, Natsuki. The tall one, whose name is apparently Yuri, seems to be quite shy compared to the others. In comparison, the girl named Natsuki, despite her size, seems like the assertive one. Well, it's nice to meet both of you. I look forward to working with you.
Working?
Ushio, don't tell me.
That's right. The club I've decided to join is yours.
The literature club. Sayori's eyes light up.
No way.
No way. So cool. Sayori wraps her arms around me, jumping up and down.
Hey.
Well, if Sayori's this happy, then I'm sure it won't be so bad to have you around. Not to mention that there's four of us now. That means we can become an officially recognised club. I don't know what to say. We have to celebrate.
Alright, what an appropriate day for this, isn't it?
Yeah, after all, Natsuki decided to...
Got them cupcakes!
Everyone sit down at the table, okay? How about I make some tea?
Yes, please.
The girls have a few desks arranged to form a table.
Natsuki and Yuri walk over to the corner of the room, where Natsuki grabs a wrapped tray and Yuri opens the closet. Still feeling awkward, I take a seat next to Sayori. Natsuki proudly marches back to the table, tray in hand.
Okay, are you ready?
Ta-da!
Oh yeah.
Natsuki lifts the foil off the tray to reveal a dozen white fluffy cupcakes decorated to look like little cats. The whiskers are drawn with icing, and little pieces of chocolate were used to make the ears.
So cute.
Well, these look really amazing.
Well, you know. Just hurry and take one.
Sayori grabs one first, then I follow.
Delicious.
Sayori talks with her mouth full and has already managed to get icing on her face. I turn the cupcake around in my fingers, looking for the best angle to take a bite.
Natsuki's quiet.
I can't help but notice her sneaking glances in my direction. Is she waiting for me to take a bite? I finally bite down. The icing is sweet and full of flavour. I wonder if she made it herself.
It's really good.
Thanks, Natsuki.
Well, of course it is. I'm a pro after all.
There's no need to thank me or anything. As Natsuki struggles to accept the compliment, Yuri returns to the table carrying a tea set. She carefully places a teacup in front of each of us before setting down the teapot next to the cupcake tray.
You keep a whole tea set in the classroom?
Don't worry, the teachers gave us permission. After all, doesn't a hot cup of tea help you enjoy a good book?
Wow, I guess.
Okay, already trying to impress our new member then, Yuri. Nah, that's not it. Insulted, Yuri looks away. I meant that, you know, I believe you. Well, tea and reading might not be a pastime for me, but I at least enjoy tea. I'm glad. Yuri faintly smiles to herself in relief. So, what kind of things do you like to read? Well, considering how little I've read the past few years, I don't really have a good way of answering that. That manga, yo. I mutter quietly to myself, half joking. Natsuki's head suddenly perks up. It looks like she wants to say something, but she keeps quiet. No, I'm not much of a reader then, I guess. Well, I guess that can change. What am I saying? I spoke without thinking after seeing Yuri's sad smile. Anyway, what about you, Yuri? Well, let's see. Yuri traces the rim of her teacup with her finger. My favourites are usually novels that build deep and complex fantasy worlds. The level of creativity and craftsmanship behind them is amazing to me. Yeah, we've had this conversation before, but now we're through the other side of all the weird stuff, so it's kind of got another meaning to it now. Telling a good story in such a foreign world is equally impressive. Yuri goes on, clearly passionate about her reading. She seems so reserved and timid since the moment I walked in, but it's obvious by the way her eyes light up, and that she finds her comfort in the world of books, not people. You know, I like a lot of things. Don't feel intimidated if you don't read much, okay? I'm certain that we can find something that we have in common. Hey, Yuri.
What?
Well, how about, you know, the first thing you said.
Manga? Yeah, let's talk about the manga. Let's get to that.
That's right, Natsuki tends to read manga in the clubroom.
Don't just say it.
For some reason, Natsuki seems embarrassed about it. Besides, manga is literature too, you know. So, if Ushio wants to read some of my manga, then don't try to stop him or anything, okay?
Natsuki, I would not do such a thing.
However, it could also be nice for us to diversify ourselves a little bit. He can take this opportunity to try something new as well.
Don't you agree?
Maybe. Sensing the tension, Sayori jumps in. Maybe we can all try something new. I think it could be fun. And we'll all get to know each other a little bit better as well. I mean, that's the kind of thing literature clubs do, don't they?
I don't disagree or anything.
Yeah, you're right as usual, President.
Nice.
I guess that means I should try picking up a novel or something.
Well, that would make two of us.
I wouldn't mind doing it if I'm not the only one.
As for Yuri, wow, you get to read some manga. I gotta read it.
Hell yeah. You were the one who suggested we diversify. You should be a little more open-minded.
It's kind of hurtful.
Hurtful? I didn't realise. With a guilty expression, Yuri thinks to herself, I'm sorry for disrespecting your interest, Natsuki. If you're into it, then I'm sure it's a worthy form of literature. The thing is, if you read in a book, that's like 5 to 10 hours. If you read in a manga, under an hour, it's not as much of a commitment. You'll be fine.
Are you just saying that?
No. I've realised my error. So, if you're willing to consider starting a novel, then I'll offer my gratitude by finding a manga to read as well.
Really?
I mean, it makes me happy that you do that for me. You can trust me to find something that you'll really like, okay?
Same.
Perhaps I'll visit the bookstore after the club meeting.
Just you?
Oh, would you like to come along then?
If you don't mind.
Not at all. I'll always go alone, so yeah, me too.
This is so cute.
Sayori, shut up.
I'll show you some of the manga there too, okay?
Alright, I look forward to it. See, now that Monica's gone, everyone's friends. Alright, Natsuki and Yuri start to clean up the food. I guess the meeting's over, right?
Yeah, looks like it.
It's nice to see everyone getting along.
Isn't it?
I think everyone likes you too.
You think so?
Well, everyone seems to get along a little bit better with you around, Sayori.
Oh, Ushio, don't say something like that. It's embarrassing.
Well, whatever. I was surprised when you told me you were starting a club, but I think you're pulling it off just fine. We're going to make it the best club ever.
Now that you joined, every day is going to be so much fun.
Hey, I really want to thank you.
I mean, I'm really happy that you joined the club and everything, but the truth is, I knew that you were going to.
What?
There's actually something else. I wanted to thank you for getting rid of Monica?
That's right. I know everything that she did.
Yeah, wasn't there a discussion earlier? Sayori, she's good at manipulating people.
Maybe it's because I'm the president now, but I really know everything.
Shit,
I know how hard you tried to make everyone happy. I know about all of the awful things that Monica did to make everyone really sad, but none of that matters anymore.
It's just us now that got me a little bit, and you made me the happiest girl in the whole world. I can't wait to spend every day like this with you. Oh, forever and ever. We're in that room again. Oh, fuck off. F-O-4-ever. No. Oh, hack. We fight him back. What's happening? I won't let you hurt him. Is Monica fighting back? Who? It hurts. Oh. I'm sorry, I was wrong. There's no happiness here after all. Goodbye, Sayori. Goodbye, Ushio. Goodbye, Literature Club. Okay. Now where are we? Oh, talking, hello.
Hi, it's me. So, you know how I've been, like, practicing piano and stuff? And not really any good at it yet, like, at all. But I wrote you a song, and I was kind of hoping that I could show it to you, because I worked really, really hard on it.
This is Monica. Monica's gonna play piano for us. Sure.
Every day I imagine a future where I can be with you.
Oh. It's just all a little bit too overbearing. It would be cute if it wasn't so creepy and stalkery.
Just move your hand right away into his heart. But in this world of infinite choices, what will it take just to find that special day? What will it take just to find?
What would it take to just to find that special day? Oh wow. Is that the end of the game? Oh wow, what a trip. Okay. Remove images. Oh, deleted successfully. Okay, bye. Yeah. I imagine this is the end of the game. I don't know if I've got the nerve to try and finish all of the hidden details and endings and stuff. But I've done it once through. And yeah, there was quite a lot to process. Really enjoyed it. I don't know if there'll be any more weird twists or jumps before the end of the credits, but we'll see. But I hope you enjoyed this game, but yeah, this is really strange. I did jump a little bit. I got really spooked after the initial twist and it kind of freaked me out, but after that, I kind of started to enjoy it a bit more. It was really fun. And I hope you enjoyed it as well, if you was able to get it past the... You need to set it up before you can knock it down. So if you can make it through that, yeah, I hope you enjoyed it as well. And this is Ushio signing off, and hopefully I will see you next time. Special thanks, Monica and Ushio. This is my final goodbye to the Literature Club. I finally understand. The Literature Club is truly a place where no happiness can be found. To the very end, it continued to expose innocent minds to horrific reality. A reality that our world was not designed to comprehend. I can't let any of my friends undergo the same hellish epiphany. For the time it lasted, I want to thank you for making all of my dreams come true, for being a friend to all the club members, and most of all, thank you for being a part of my literature club. With everlasting love, Monica. Okay, Scriptfire is corrupt. Reinstall the game. What? Seriously? Just gonna try and reopen the game just to see what it looks like. Here it comes. That's it! It's gone. I imagine there is a way to try the game again. I imagine you have to go back into the game file and find something. There probably has to be something here. I think it's this file. Look, first run, 1 kilobyte. Let's get rid of that. Delete. Okay, let's try that again. A previous save file has been found. Would you like to delete your save data and start over? Yeah. If you hit no, then that first run file reappears. But yeah, delete that. Deleting saved data. Here we go. It's a complete reset. So you can start the game again and try and get different endings, I suppose. Cool.